If you ask me for an offering, I'd give it. If you want a sacrifice, I would obey. But my life is all I have, and I will live it, dedicated to the honor of your...
Shalom Aleichem. I am Messenger Daniel. It is in the name of Yahuwah. Welcome back, Yahushua Ministries. Say Shalom Aleichem. Peace being today. To all my Israeli brothers and sisters, no matter where you are, we have been deceived for almost 2,000 years of religion deceptions. It is a time now, Abba Yahweh, remember his covenant he was make with the house of Israel, with our forefathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. So he reserved a remnant for himself to bring him into to today. The scripture talking about the God of this world. So why the scripture refer about the God of this world? And he has not Yahweh of paradise. 2 Corinthians 4 and 4. And whom the God of this world has blinded the mind of them which believe not, lest the light of the same good news should shine on them. There is only one being who wants to blind this world to the truth of the real good news of Messiah Yahushua, Satan the devil. Understand the true good news is about the prophecy soon coming, the kingdom of Abba Yahweh. But this kingdom, as Messiah Yahushua said in John 18:36, my kingdom is not of this world. As 2 Corinthians 4 and 4 state that the God of this world. So Abba Yahweh cannot be a creator of this world, or the kingdom of Yahweh cannot be of this world, when the scripture say the God of this world. Who is the God of this world? The devil. 2 Corinthians 4 and 4. Let's read it again and you can try to understand. How can this world belong to the devil? It's not belong to Yahushua. Or can you can be participate in voting and choose a leader to be a wicked presidents or leaders doing what is wrong against Abba Yahweh? 2 Corinthians 4 and 4, talking about God of this world. Who is the God of this world? And that is not Yahweh of paradise? No. 2 Corinthians 4 and 4 state that, and whom the God of this world, as Messiah Yahushua said in John 18:36, my kingdom is not of this world. Read my lips. As 2 Corinthians 4 and 4 say, the God of this world. So when you say God, you're serving the devil. Because the devil is the God of this world. That's the reason why Messiah Yahushua said, you shall have no other gods before me. Because Yahweh is the creator and he has a name. My Israeli brothers and sisters, I believe every single person in this earth, they believe. I respect their belief. But guess what? They serve a God without name. Because everybody, every denomination say, God, 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 God. But what is the name of your God? When the scripture say, according to 2 Corinthians 4 and 4, say the God of this world. Who is the God of this world? Do they refer to Yahweh, the creator of the paradise, the earth, and the sea? Absolutely not. The scripture refers to the devil as the God of this world, who is blinded the mind of unbelievers. When your pastors, your minister, your leaders say to choose a leader, they are blinding your mind. When Messiah Yahushua say, my kingdom is not of this world. If my kingdom was of this world, do my servant would find for me not to rest from the leaders of Israelites? Messiah Yahushua said, Pilate, that's why I was born. I was coming to this world to be a king, to be testified against the devil, against the ruler of the darkness. So because of this, there is so many deception today. For almost 2,000 years, lot of pastors and ministers knowing to be the truth, but they are refused to tell the mass as we come to our understanding, do Messiah Yahushua give the disciple power and authority to choose a man or politicians to be their leaders? When there is only one being who wants to be blind, this world of the truth is the devil of the real good news. It's blinded the mind of the people who do not believe, not to be believed in Messiah Yahushua, for the light should be shine upon them. They can receive salvation. That's why your pastor, your ministers told you to go choose a leader when Messiah Yahushua say, my kingdom is not of this world. Well, understand the true good news is about the prophecy soon coming, the kingdom of Abba Yahweh. That's why on the prayer, Messiah Yahushua say, may thy will be done, may your kingdom come. Until Yahweh kingdom do not come, the devil is still rule the earth. The devil is the god of this world. Even Yahweh is in control, but the devil will do it. I'm going to tell you something, my friend. Throughout this story, any country or any party who don't have Yahweh in their life is a waste. Just like right now in the United States of America, they enter into dark age. The dark age means they will set Yahweh on the publics. They remove Yahweh commitment, even in the school, their prayers, and everything. They reject Yahweh completely. But in all the money, from a penny until $100 bill, they say, and God with us. What is the meaning of and God with us when they remove the prayers and the commitment of Yahweh on the face of the earth? All the private school, they say, oh, because of I respect other belief. By the time Yahweh give only one Torah, one commitment for everybody who living on the face of the earth. Abba Yahweh do not create religion. The devil create religion to divide humanity. If Abba Yahweh give only one scripture, as he say, the scripture say according to 2 Corinthians, verse 3 and 6, 2 Timothy 3 and 16, it state that the scripture is the only word inspired by Yahweh. There is no other books inspired by Yahweh. But the scripture himself is inspired by Yahweh to do what? For correcting, for rebuking, for direction, and to make one wise in the righteousness. So there is no other book. People can write any other book, but they are not inspired by Yahweh. They are inspired by men. But the word, the Torah, was inspired by Yahweh. The Torah, the commandment, was written with Yahweh's own fingers and was speaking by Yahweh's own mouth. As he said, it is written, according to the book of Exodus, 20 chapter verse 1, for Yahweh has spoken all these words. Not Yahweh used a donkey, or a prophet, or a man. He used his own mouth to give Moses the 10 commandments for anybody who living on the face of the earth should believe according to the commandment he has been given on the Mount Sinai 3500 years ago. But today, because choose so much excuse, so many excuses because of their belief. Which belief it is when there is one Torah? Which belief it is when Abba Yahweh give his commitment for whomsoever live on the face of this earth should believe according to the word of Yahweh? That's the reason why when the temptation, when the devil tell me, say, if you are the son of Yahweh, can you turn this stone into bread? Messiah say, it is written, man cannot live alone by bread alone, but only by the words came from Yahweh's mouth. What is the word came from Yahweh's mouth? The commandments. But today, there is so many excuses, or because of their belief. There is only one book, according to 2 Timothy 3, verse 16. There is only one book, the scripture. All the scripture is inspired by Yahweh's words. Inspired by Yahweh. All his prophets inspired by Yahweh. They are not man-made teaching. So if today there is so many excuses because they reject Yahweh, so they have to give you excuse why they reject Yahweh on the pulpit of the prophets. So the children, they teach them about sex, but they don't teach them how to pray. They don't know about the commandment, the rule of nature. The nature governed by a covenant. The covenant is to obey Yahweh commandments. No matter what your belief is, there is a Torah for everybody. Yahweh gave the Torah, he gave the five book of Torah, not even he write the commandment in his own fingers, and he put them down on the two stone of tablets. Why he write them on the two stone of tablets? Because he want to be preserved for life. He don't put a piece of paper, write them down with a pen. Yahweh write them with his own finger. Oh, come today, you can turn me, or because of their belief. What kind of belief it is? When you rejected Yahweh, do Abraham going to raise Moses for 40 years on the wilderness, teach the children of Israel about his commandment, and today to raise another prophet to go contrary to what he said? Abraham is not the author of confusion, my friend. As the book of 1 Corinthians 14 verse 23 state that Abraham is not the author of confusions, but the author of lie and peace. If Abayahweh is not the author of confusions, who is the author of confusion? The devil. How can there is so many believe when there is only one creator? How can there is so many demonizations when there is only one creator? How can there is so many religions when there is only one creator? Kingdom divide against kingdom cannot be stand, my friend. That's why we divide ourselves. The devil know his trick, he know he divide you by religion. Show me on the scripture, from Genesis to Revelation, where he talking about religions. Where there is Christians, Christianity, Protestant, Seventh-day Adventist, or Pentecost, or Lutheran, or whatsoever. Show me on the scripture, and I'm going to tell Yahweh, you are a liar, you are a lunatic, I don't want to serve you. Just give me evidence where there is a religion. But I can give you evidence from Genesis to Revelation talking about the children of Israel. Who are the children of Israel today? Where are they? Because of disobedience, Abayahweh dispersed them. Now it is a time Abayahweh remember the covenant he made with Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. He will bring a remnant, he will serve a remnant for his own self. To remain deceived because of their belief. Because you are living and the country is controlled by the devil. USA, United States of America, that's what they tell you. But it's not the way it is. Under Satan authority. That's why the rule by the devil, that's why you don't even can discipline your own child. Because the devil tell you, hey, they are mine. You cannot do whatever you want to them with them, to discipline them, but they have the right to shoot them, to put them in jail, and to beat them for you. But you yourself, as your son, you carry them for 9 months, but you cannot discipline them. But they have the power, the authority to shoot them, to put them in jail, and to beat them for you. You cannot discipline them, but they have the power and authority to discipline them for you. That's the reason why there is so much corruption, so much deception of this world. Because remember, Revelation 12:9 said the dragon, the old serpent, called the devil, deceive the whole world. How can one being can deceive the whole world? Just remember, he was cast out with his angel. Who are those angels? Those ministers, those pastors, those imposters, they are represent the devil because they work for the devil. In order for any man to be on the high places, they have to be serving the devil. As at the temptation, when you take the book of Luke, 4 chapter verse 5, the devil take Yahushua, throw him on the high place. He said, all those kingdoms, they are mine. That's why the devil said to Yahushua, they can be yours too. Only one thing you have to do, that action is to bow down and worship me. If The devil know who is Yahushua. He tell Yahushua, don't lose your time to save your people. Just come to me. I will give you all those kingdoms. Worship me, bow down to me. You don't have to go through this. Don't do it. I will give you anything. Just come, join me. As the scripture says, I mean, there's a proverb say, if you cannot beat them, join them. Guess what? In my dead body, I cannot join you. I will challenge you. I want to beat you, but I don't want to join you, my friend. Because I would like to prove to you, by the spirit of liar, you are a liar. By the spirit of Yahweh, you are nothing deceiving people. I can never join you because I don't want your riches. Because naked I'm coming, and naked I'm come back. I'm coming in my mother with nothing. When I go back, I cannot carry nothing with me. So may Yahweh will as to be done on earth, as it is right now in paradise. So no matter what you take, my friend, you take any one way. There is only one being who wants to blind humanity, only the devil. This word of the truth of the real good news of Messiah Yahushua, understand the true good news, is about the prophecy soon coming, the kingdom of Yahweh. Yahweh world ruling government, my brothers and sisters, Messiah Yahushua is praying. Oh, Messiah Yahushua is going to return and establish Yahweh kingdom to replace the devil. It is not strange then if Satan wants to block people from understanding this miserable truth. He wants you to go down with him on the pit. He don't want you to know the truth. Because Messiah Yahushua said in John 8:31-32, if you abide in my words, you are indeed my disciple. In order for you to be Messiah Yahushua's disciple, you have to abide. When you abide, there is a bond and his word. Him and his word is one. And you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free. But the devil don't want you to set you free, because he wants to keep you in captivities and prison in order to do his will. That was his job. That was, he was telling Yahweh. He said, Yahweh, I will come in. I will make everybody worship me. And Yahweh said, okay, go ahead. If you think you can do it, just go ahead. The same war, the Revelation 12:7 talking about, the war still keep on going until Yahushua coming back. The war gonna be gone. If you don't lead by the spirit of Yahweh, if you don't have all the armor of Messiah Yahushua, I'm telling you, my friend, you will be deceived, because he knows, he's good at it. He is very intelligent, but only one thing, Yahweh said, the wisdom of this world is nothing but foolishness. Because the big houses, the big corporate jet, the big house, the big things you get, they are nothing but vanities upon vanity and vexation of the spirit. You can take nothing with you. Money cannot buy a good friend. Money cannot buy love. Money cannot buy life. If money can buy life, Michael Jackson will still be alive today. Whitney Houston will be still alive today. If money can buy life, a lot of people still alive today. So whatever you believe, my friend, they tell you wrong. Money can just buy contentment. Money is not a destination. Money is not a journey. Money is just a way of life. Without the money, you can do nothing. Because the devil created that way. But at the ancient time, there was no money. You get something and trade it, and there is no crimes. There is no war. There is no greed. There was no selfishness. Now, because of money, as I say, I will say it again, only 1% people who govern rule over 99%. I don't believe that. Only 1% who control the money, and 99% people are under the rules. The devil is rule the earth. Even Abraham is still in control, but the God of this world still in control. No light shining on is not that is despite. In time, when Yahushua will be banished from his current position of worldwide influence, there is a time the devil will be locked out. There is a time Messiah Yahushua will lock the devil out in order he will be banished. But now it is his time, because he's gonna try to get anyone he can take. My friend, as I say, put Yahweh first in your life. Pray. If you know how to pray two times, now I'm telling you to quadruple it. Pray eight times, because America is under that age. America is under judgment. Not America, the people who are living in the United States of America. Because America is just a name, but the people. They are under judgment of Yahweh. They are under the punishment because of the wicked ways, because of the sin, because of the iniquities against Yahweh. So the devil is blinding the mind of the people not to believe on the good news. For the election to come, I'm telling you, if you are believing Yahweh again and again, I'm warning you not to be taken part in any politics affair. Not to vote for any man, neither is open, Democrat or Republicans, no matter what name they are working for the same devil. Yahweh won't let you to know what is going on. It is a chess match. Be careful what you're doing. Your pastor is working for the devil. Do not listen to it. Listen to the word of Yahweh. Three times in the good news. Three times on the good news, Messiah Yahushua himself referred to Satan, the devil, as the prince of this world. If the devil is the prince of this world, how can somebody believe in Yahushua, not on Jesus Christ? There is a difference between Jesus Christ and Messiah Yahushua. Because Jesus Christ is a common name. Jesus Christ is not the person who died for me and for you in Golgotha. Because when he was born, there is no English speaking. So there is a confusion. Messiah Yahushua never intervened in politics. Maybe Jesus intervened in politics, but not Yahushua. Even his servant also, Yahushua, never involved in the politics. If Messiah Yahushua himself explained about and the good news, so he referred to the devil as the prince of this world. When we take John 12 chapter verse 31, John 16, 11, and John 14 verse 30, Messiah Yahushua made plain that the future of the prince of this world will be judging, because as Messiah Yahushua said in John 14, 30, the devil has nothing in me. Take time to read that verse. John 12 chapter verse 31, parallel the judgment of this world with Satan coming judgment. This is because this is his world. This world is belong to the devil. Messiah Yahushua stepped himself three times into a vision. So the devil is the prince of this world. If the devil is the prince of this world, how can we can compare Yahushua, Yahweh, as the prince of this world, the devil, the God of this world? How? There is a confusion, my friend. You been be deceived for almost 2,000 years of religion deception. The man you trust, your pastor, the man you trust has been deceived you for almost 2,000 years. They been keep you captive to do the devil will, but Abba Yahweh wants you to listen to his voice. As Messiah Yahushua say, my kingdom is not of this world. If Messiah Yahushua's kingdom is not of this world, how can you can be participate in voting and politics when the politics, this government is nothing but demonic? It represents the devil. Messiah Yahushua, remember, talking about the prince of this world, we turn into judgment. That's why the people in the United States is under that age. I'm going to give you a secret, my friend. In the time of King Nebuchadnezzar and his son Belshazzar, Abba Yahweh would choose Prophet Daniel. Are you think now is some coincidence or some accident Abba Yahweh choose a other Daniel to warn the wicked president of the United States of America? Just that Abba Yahweh would choose Daniel to warn him Belshazzar, a wicked king of Babylon. And guess what? United States is Babylon the Great. he fight with us in Babylon. That's why the scriptures say, Babylon the Great is falling. Yes, it is falling. The fall of the Republic never looked better. Why, Mr. Obama? You know what you're doing. Yes, the Greek Republic of the United States of America is on the curse. It is falling. It is falling apart. Because Abba Yahweh in writing already put the judgment in Mr. Obama's desk. Babylon the Great is falling. He is falling. And no matter who, but as I say, it's too early. Do not count Mr. Obama out yet. Don't count him out. Because he has to fulfill what he has to fulfill. When we take the book of Matthew, 4th chapter contains the well-known account of Messiah Yahushua's confrontation with the devil after fasting for 40 days. The devil repeatedly tempted Messiah Yahushua through twisting scripture. One of these favorite devices at one point is verses 8 and 9. The devil took him up into an exceedingly high mountain and showed him all the kingdom of this world and the glory of them, the steel of them. And the devil said to Messiah Yahushua, all these things will I give it to you. All these things will I give it to you. I will fall down. If you fall down and worship me, I will give it to you. So all those people who become president or senator or whatsoever they are, they must bow down to the devil. Because the key of this kingdom, the key of this world, the devil have it. Because Adam was given to him when Adam fell to control his dominions. Now the devil have dominion on this earth. Until Messiah Yahushua coming back, put him on the pit. So when we take, the offer is more in Israeli tongue, meet the eyes. Why? Notice that Messiah Yahushua rebuke Satan in verse 10, quoting Deuteronomy 6:13, and weapons and answer, you shall worship Yahweh, your creator, and Yahweh only shall you serve. Only you. I'm talking to you, those pastors. The same verse Messiah Yahushua quote to the devil. You shall not tempt Yahweh, your creator. Yahweh only you should be served. So when you serve the devil, my friend, no matter how much money you get, you cannot bring it with you. No matter how many gold and silvers you collect, you cannot bring them with you. So it is better, my friend, for you to suffer now and rejoice in the future. I better be suffering now and rejoice in the future. It's better to suffer when you are young, and when you are old, you can rejoice. Now you get strength, you have courage to endure. Because there is so many ways, I don't want to go to that today. Because Mr. Yahushua said, those who endure till the end, they are same who gonna say, you have to endure, you have to overcome this world. If you cannot overcome this world, you cannot enter the kingdom of Yahweh. And I'm gonna show you the scripture, my friend. I don't just tell you to make you afraid, but I'm gonna tell you the truth, and the truth will make me free. Now, when the judgment day coming, when you appear before the judge, Messiah Yahushua, you cannot say, I do not know. That's the reason why Messiah Yahushua say the good news of the kingdom of Abba Yahweh must be preached as a witness. As a witness. I mean, the world itself going to be a witness against you. Not Yahushua, but the word of Yahweh going to be a judgment against you. The word of Yahweh is going to judge you. You cannot say, I do not know. That's the reason why Messiah Yahushua give time. He said, his kingdom must be preached everywhere in the world as a witness. Do you know what a witness means? Then the end shall come. Until that, humanity is going to be suffering. Because everybody has to know the kingdom of Abraham is at hand to repent from your wicked ways. This kingdom is not belong to Yahweh. This kingdom belong to the devil. The devil ruled the earth because Adam was given the dominion over the earth. When we take this offer, Messiah Yahushua say this offer was unusual to meet. Yet notice that at one point, Did Yahushua say, "This kingdom is not yours"? Mr. Yahushua never said to the devil, "This kingdom is not yours." Why he don't say they are not yours? And today people can say, "Oh, they are not belong to the devil." But do Mr. Yahushua say they are not yours? Because Mr. Yahushua know they are belong to him. That's why he don't say they do not belong. He don't waste no time. He say Yahweh, your creator, you should be served. He don't say those kingdoms, they are not yours. Because he knows, Messiah Yahushua knows, those kingdoms belong to the devil. Messiah Yahushua never say, "Those kingdoms he had not yours to give." Or who do you think you are, lying to offer me what is already Yahweh? Messiah Yahushua never say that. Nowhere on the scripture say, Messiah Yahushua say, "Hey, why you lie to me? Why you offer me what is already mine?" Messiah Yahushua never say that. If Messiah Yahushua never say that, but why today we can take in this world is belong to Yahweh when the devil is the one who rule over it? Messiah Yahushua said no such thing again. Why? Because he knew that the government, the kingdom of this world, are the devil government. That's why he don't say no, because he know his kingdom not yet to come. Because his kingdom did not come to them, who is the kingdom now? Who is ruled as a king? The devil. That's why we have to be careful. Messiah Yahushua knew that they belong to the devil. Were Satan to give, therefore he reject the terms to receiving the kingdom from the one who have authority to offer to him. Hello. The devil promised you 10. But guess what? Whatever he offered you, you cannot go with nothing. Because he knows you cannot carry them with you. He knows whatever you do. Because Yahweh was given the power and authority to take everything away from you. Because he's so self-arrogant, he tells Yahweh, "Job serves you because you're blessing him." But I bet you, if you take everything away from Job, Job will not gonna serve you. Because Job serves you because of what you give it to him. Yahweh said, "My servant Job, I give you power and authority. Take everything again and see." That same Job, even his wife say, "You have something you're hiding. Why you don't curse Yahweh and go over it?" He say, "Woman, you're talking just like a foolish woman." That same Job, the scripture say he never see a word, he never sinned against Yahweh. That same Job who lose everything, even his body was infected at one point. He shaved his head, he put down his knees, he said, "Naked I was coming in my mother's womb. Naked I will go back." Yahweh is the one who give. Yahweh is the one who take. May the name of Yahweh must be blessed. There is no other faith than that. Yahweh knows, because he knows the faith Job gave is not because what he was given to Job, but because Job have a faith inside. But the devil was self-arrogant. He said, "Yahweh, Job served you because you give him this." Yahweh said, "If you think so, go ahead and try." And the same thing, he even tried Messiah Yahushua. If you don't have to go to the tree. You don't have to go to the stake. Don't go to that man. Come and join me. That's why he was offering Yahushua all this kingdom. Don't go to that man. Come and join me. Hey, you're going to get all the joys, all those toys. You can get everything if you join my team. Messiah Yahushua said, Yahweh only you should be served. Just like your pastor have been deceived you. Your pastor has been lied to you. Just like the devil is a liar from the foundation of the earth. Now it's time for you to wake up. Let's take about the book of Exodus 32, chapter verse 32. Let's see what happened. "But now, please forgive their sin, but if you not, erase my name from the book you have written." There is a time when the children of Israel sinned against Yahweh. Moses go before Yahweh. He tell Yahweh, "Please forgive their children because of their sin. Or if you don't want to forgive their sin, blot me out of the book you was written." Listen what Yahweh said to Moses. Verse 33. "But Yahweh replied to Moses, 'No, I will not erase your name But everyone who has sinned against me, I will destroy them. Are you get? Moses say, Yahweh, why you get all the children of Israel? Why you have to destroy them? Destroy me, blot out of my name on your book. Yahweh say, you are not the one who sinned against me. They are the one who sinned against me. Get away from me, let me destroy them, and I will give you another people. When people talk in Yahweh, Yahweh is love. What kind of love Yahweh is? Listen in verse 34. Now go, lead the people to the place I told you about. Look, my angel will lead you the way before you. However, the time comes for me to punish. I will punish them for their sin. This is Yahweh of love, your prayer with. He tells Moses, get away from him. He said, go before my angel and go to that place. I will show you where I'm going to punish them. And you tell me Yahweh is love. The love of Yahweh, my friend, is to obey his commandment. Yahweh said, I chastise those who are love. Abba Yahweh love is not to laugh and murder at you. And Abba Yahweh word cannot be compromised or cannot be sold. Abba Yahweh kingdom is not a free market or Publix or Winn-Dixie. No matter how much children you get, you can earn it by obeying Abba Yahweh commandment and by doing Yahweh will. If not, you go into hell. I'm telling you. This is what it is. Because if Yahweh, verse 35, then Yahweh sent a great plague. This is Yahweh, your sage love. Read Exodus 32 chapter, verse 33 to 35. And you will see who is Yahweh. Yahweh said, then Yahweh sent a great plague upon the people because they had worshipped the calf and other gods. So when you worship Amen, you put destruction upon your own self. Do Yahweh love you? Of course, yes. Maybe you might be thinking, I hate you. Because I'm telling the truth. No. Because of the love of Yahweh. Because when you take the book of John 3, chapter verse 17, state that Abba Yahweh never sent his son Yahushua to condemn his people, not the world. Because the world is belong to the devil. The devil will never be a part of the kingdom of Yahweh. He never said the world, but only his people. But through Messiah Yahushua, his people, the children of Israel, might be saved. Not this world, because this world belongs to the devil. The devil will never be repent. That the misinterpretations, again, John 3, 17, is a misinterpretation. When they say, Abba will not send his son in this world for his son to condemn this world. No, this world already condemned. But his people, through Yahushua, the children of Israel might be saved, not this world again. That's a misinterpretation, my friend. So there is so many gaps on the scripture. There is so many misinterpretations, so many deceptions. So you have to have the spirit of Abba Yahweh in order you can do. And Exodus 32, verse 35, then Yahweh sent a great plague, just like he's going to send now in the United States of America and all over the world. Whatever you see now, the disease, the sickness, the plagues, is nothing yet, my friend, compare what Abba Yahweh going to do to these people. By refusing to obey Yahweh commandments, to obey Abba Yahweh words, my friends, I'm afraid. I hope I can take your place. Because I don't even want to touch the book of Revelation yet. Because it's too fearful, it's too horrible to talk about what's going to be happening. The seventh seal, the seventh plagues, the seventh trumpet. I mean, you do not know, my friends. When we take the book of 1 Peter 2, chapter verse 21, for Yahweh called you to go to the good news, even in me, Messiah, who are suffering for you, leaving you an example that you should be followed and instead. Listen carefully, my friend. If Messiah Yahushua call you today to do good, even if me, Messiah Yahushua, suffer for you, leaving you an example that you should follow his step, not following the footstep of Michael Jordan or LeBron James, but follow the footstep of Messiah Yahushua. Be on the same mindset of Messiah Yahushua. If Messiah Yahushua say, my kingdom is not of this world, if you are a servant, you represent a kingdom, you are an ambassador to another country, can you vote? Are you of any power or any authority to vote when you are only an ambassador? You are a foreigner. How can you can vote when you are a stranger to a country if this kingdom is not belong to you? Tell me, my friend, we should be example to Messiah first step. If Messiah should never be participate in main politics or in the vote to choose a leader, why should they make you think then it is okay for you to choose a leader in your own who will bring you to destruction? When we take the book of Philippians 2 chapter verse 5, you must have the same attitude that Messiah Yahushua had. What it means? You have to have the same attitude. What attitude means? The same manner, the same principle, and the same word. If the word of Messiah Yahushua and your word is different, something is wrong with you, my friend. With my lips and with the scripture. When we take the book of Philippians 2 chapter verse 5, you must have the same attitude, the same mindset, the same spirit with Messiah Yahushua that Messiah Yahushua had. If you say you are a servant of Messiah Yahushua, you walk in different ways. Your language is different with Messiah Yahushua language. Something is wrong with you. Because a man should weep whatever he sows. Whatever you did, my friend, guess what? It may take time, but you're going to pay for it no matter what. That's why Abba always say, according to Acts 17 chapter verse 30, in the time of ignorance, Abba Yahweh overlook. Even he overlook, he going to slap you no matter what. But now command every man, everywhere, not someplace, but everywhere, including the United States of America, to repent from their wicked ways. Because Abba Yahweh has already appointed a time to judge the wicked people, just like he did in the time of Noah and in the time of Lot. Remember the city of Sodom and Gomorrah. If the city of Sodom and Gomorrah was received the same kind of preaching, the same kind of sermon, United States of America and the world received, they will still stand today. The people from Nineveh gonna wake up and judge the people of this world. Because the people as Nineveh was listening to Prophet Jonah, they repent and Yahweh saved Nineveh from their destruction. If the people of United States of America and everywhere in the world listen to the word of Abba Yahweh and repent, just like the king Nineveh was did, even the horses, the animals would fast and pray, and Abba Yahweh would have mercy upon them. If Abba Yahweh can spare the city of Nineveh, if people in the United States of America, by fasting and prayer, go before Abba Yahweh and repent your sin, Abba Yahweh may have the same mercy, same compassion over you. As Abba Yahweh say, I desire mercy, not sacrifices. If anybody thinking Abba Yahweh is just love, you think it's a free market, there is a free way? My friend, no way. Salvation is free, but eternal life is not free. You get to work your way to it. Faith without work is dead. That's that it is impossible for you to beat a dead horse. When we take the book of 2 Corinthians 6:17, listen what it says. Therefore, come out from among unbelievers. Who are the unbelievers? The devil. Because they not believe in Yahweh, and they will never believe in Abba Yahweh. And depart, separate yourself from them, said Yahweh. Don't touch the filthy things, and I will welcome you. Abba Yahweh said, do not touch the filthy things. Who are the filthy things? The money, the wealth, the corporate jet, the big buildings. Abba Yahweh said, do not touch. 2 Corinthians 6:17. Therefore, come out from among unbelievers. He said, come out from the devil. come out from this world and separate yourself from them. From what? From this world, said Yahweh. I don't say it, Yahweh say it. Don't touch the filthy things and I will welcome you. Only one thing for Abba Yahweh to welcome you is to not participate in the devil's supper. If you are, sell your soul to the devil, my friend. Your time is already done. You already gone to hell with them because you accept the condition. The same way Abba Yahweh don't give nothing without conditions, the same way the devil don't give nothing without the condition. Remember, before Abba Yahweh put Adam on the garden, he tell Adam, you may eat everything freely, but except the tree on the middle of the garden, the tree of knowledge, the good and evil, the day you eat it, you shall die. But the devil say to the woman, you shall not die, for Yahweh knows, and the day you eat on the tree, your eyes will be open. You will be just like Yahweh, knowing the good and evil. So the woman say, the tree of the fruit was good to eat, and the eyes, it was good to make one wise. She ate it, and she went to Adam. Do Adam have every power to say yes or no? Yes, he had that authority, but he was love the woman more, he loved Yahweh. Today, if you love the world more than you love Yahweh, you already gone to the hell with the world, with the devil. When you take Psalm chapter 1, verse 1, blessed is the one who does not walk and step with the wicked, or stand on the way of that sinner, take or sit in the company of his scoffers, but whose delight in the commandment of Yahweh, and who meditated on his commandment day and night. The world tell you, in order for you to be succeed, you have to be an engineer, an architect, a doctor, or to be this. But Yahweh say, if you meditate in my word day and night, this is the only way to be prosper. This is only one way. But they told you, you have to go to school. But Moses spent 40 years on the wilderness. There is no ABCD of mathematics or science. There is only the Torah, the commandment of Yahweh. That's why Moses will spend 40 years, not 40 days, not 40 hours, not 40 weeks, but about 40 long years. He teach only one thing in order the children of Israel may get them. But guess what? Even 40 years after 5 million priests, war plus women and children was dead, only two people went to the promised land, all them destroyed in the wilderness because of unbelief. My friend, Yahweh do not change. The wilderness is going to be a second time. You have a choice. Belief or unbelief. Remember, if you not believe, you are a part of the devil, because the devil will never repent. The choice is yours. When we take the verse 3, that person is like a tree planted by stream of water, which yield its fruit and season, and whose leaf does not wither. Whatever they do, they will prosper. Only one thing for you to prosper, whatever you do, is to obey Yahweh's commandment. If you sell your soul to the devil, that not prosperous. That not prosper. Because your life is going to be short, because you sell your soul to the devil. Let's take the book of 2 Corinthians 7, chapter verse 1. Therefore, since we have this promise different, let us purify ourselves from everything that can defile our bodies or spirit, and let us walk toward complete separateness, because for you are from Yahweh. Everybody from Yahweh must overcome this world. Because Messiah Yahushua, there is so many things he said, we have to know exactly what Messiah Yahushua said. When we take the book of Jeremiah 51 verse 6, flee from Babylon, run for your life. Do not be destroyed with her because of her sin. It is time for Yahweh's vengeance. He will repay her what she deserves. I feel sorry for humanity, believe me. They know Yahweh's love, they see Yahweh's love, but they do not understand. So read Jeremiah 51 verse 6, what shall we say to you? Flee from Babylon the Great, flee from America. Run for your life. Do not be destroyed with her because of her sins. It is time for Yahweh's vengeance. He will repay her with what she deserves. Jeremiah 10 verse 2, Yahweh say, this is what Yahweh say. Do not learn the ways of the nations who try to read the future and the stars. Do not be afraid of their predictions. Even two other nations are terrified by them. So Abraham will say, hear, O Israel, the word of Yahweh which command to speak to you, O house of Israel. This is what Yahweh says. Do not learn the ways of the nation. Do not wait to the way of the Samaritan. Do not wait to the way of the United States of America or Egypt of any nations. If we are belong to Abba Yahweh, it is a must to listen to the word of Yahweh. And I say, do not try. Those people are trying to read their future and the stars. That's why they have horoscope. Horoscope is not biblical. It's not scriptural. It's created by the devil to tell you your sign. That doesn't exist. That's the devil. That's deception. That's why the scripture says, they try to read their future and the stars. Do not be afraid of the predictions. Even two other nations terrified by them, but do not. Because they believe in lying things and they lie to you by telling you, you are Taurus, you are this, you are this. When we take the book of Numbers, 16 chapter verse 21, separate yourself from those people so that I may consume them in a moment. Yahweh will warn the children of Israel, get out from them, because Abayahweh is ready to consume them. It's up to you, my friend. Read it for yourself. Numbers 16, chapter verse 21. Separate yourselves from these people so that I may consume them in a moment. Verse 26. Moses warned the assembly. He told the people, get away from the tents of these wicked men and don't touch anything that belongs to them. If you do, you will destroy with them for the sins. What more do we expect it? Moses warning the assembly. He told the people, get away from the tent of these wicked men and do not touch anything that belongs to them. If you do, you will destroy with them for the sins. That's funny? No, it's not. Just start today. Whatever you touch from the seven, whatever you touch with the devil, my friend, you're going to be destroyed with the devil. Because Abba will warn you. Get away from them. Get out from them. Leave them alone. Do not touch anything because I will consume them in a moment. Yahweh anger when he strikes his finger. Hey, my friend. 1 second. 1 split second. Do you know if Yahweh anger for 5 minutes? You're talking about nuclear weapons, but you're not talking about Yahweh anger. When he slapped his finger only for 1 second, you see what catastrophe is made. Not 1 minute, not 1 second, split second. That's why he said, get out from that and I will consume them in a moment. Yahweh can consume them in 1 second if you want to. Not 1 minute, in 1 second. It's up to you to listen to Yahweh or not. When we take the book Ezra, 10 chapter verse 11, now confess your sin to Yahweh, the Creator, the Father of your forefather, and do what Yahweh said. Do what Yahweh has commanded you to do. Separate yourself from the people of the land and from the pagan women. I don't say that, my friend. Proverbs 9 and 6. Leave your simple ways behind and begin to live, learn to do good, because the judgment of Yahweh is at hand. What more do you anybody expect them to get? What more? Yahushua said, come out from among them. So that's up to you if you don't want particularly in a sin, because a sin already reached into paradise. When we take the book of 1 John 2 chapter verse 15, it said that, do not love the world or anything in the world. If anyone loves the world, the love of Yahweh is not in them. Are you hear that? Those pastors, those imposters, those false shepherds, I'm talking to you, my friend, with 1 John 2, chapter verse 15. Do not love the world or things or any things in this world. If anyone, not exception, if anyone love the world, the love of Yahweh is not in him. So if the scripture warning you to not love the world, just like those pastors, they love the thing in this world, not even they love this world, but they love the thing of this world. The big couple jet, the big house, the big insurance, that all things, they are the things of this world. You cannot love them. Naked you come in and naked you go back. If you love them, you are not have any inheritance from Yahweh kingdom. And when we take the book of Matthew 6 chapter verse 24, no one can serve two masters. For you will be hate one and love the others, or you will be devoted to one and despise the other. You cannot serve both Yahweh and money at the same time, my friend. A lot of the pastors thinking they can fake Yahweh. They can serve two masters, but no man can serve two masters, my friend. How can you love two masters? How can you serve two masters? Can you serve the devil? When Messiah said, no man can serve two masters, Yahweh and money. Money means the devil, because the devil is the one who created the money. So if you love the money, you cannot love money and love Yahweh at the same time, because you love the devil and you love Yahweh at the same time. You can't. So if you love money, you're going to die in your corruption, because the devil created the money to entice you. The devil create the money in order to tempt you, in order he say, hey, I can give you anything. If he can tempt Yahushua, he can tempt anybody. Isaiah 47 verse 12, keep on them with your magic spell and with your magic sorceries, which you have worked and sense with all. Perhaps you will succeed, perhaps you will cause terrors. That's why you see happening in the United States of America. Somebody caused terrorists because they tried to do a lot of things, magic and everything. They say they're going to moon, they're going to this. They do a lot of things. There's a country with 240 different demonizations. So there's all kinds of spirit living in the United States of America. I'm going to close it to that one, to that verse. Let's take a Revelation 18 chapter verse 1 to see what he says. Revelation 18 chapter verse 1, he's saying carefully what the scripture warning says. After these, I saw another angel come down from paradise. He had a great authority, and the earth was illuminated by his splendor. Verse 2, with a mighty voice he shouted, fallen, fallen, Babylon the great is fallen. Who is fallen? America. He is fallen. She become a womb of demons. When you see America, it become a habitation of demons. Everyone possessed by evil, but nobody see that. But it is written. It's right there on the scripture. Falling, falling is Babylon, the great is falling. She become a womb of demons, a habitation of demons, and hunt for every evil spirit. You never know that. I give you a little secret. So America become a dwell for evil spirit. That's why there is so many crimes, so many things happen. That's why people doing so many wicked ways, new things. In the face of Abba Yahweh, they reject Abba Yahweh. Any people in any country who reject Abba Yahweh, they enter into that age. They enter into doom. This is the last mistake for anybody to ever make in their life, is to reject Abba Yahweh. When you reject Abba Yahweh, my friend, you are doomed to death. You already condemn yourself by rejecting Yahweh. And when you take the verse 3, it says, and for every unclean and abomination birds. Verse 3, for all the nations have drunk the maiden wife on earth adultery. The king of the earth, who is the king of the earth, the devil, commit adultery with her, and a domination of the earth grew rich from the exercise luxuries. When you say the United States of America, that's very marvelous, eh? Then I heard another voice from paradise say, come out of her, my people, so that you will not share in her sins, so that you will not receive any and her plagues. For her sin are already part into paradise, and Yahweh has remembered a crime. This is this, my friend. The same one you eat. It is a warning. For all of you, Yahweh say, come out of the system. Come out of her. Because the United States of America become a habitation of demons. Everybody possessed by evil spirit. If you don't want to participate in the plagues, because the evil spirit is a plague, I will send that because he confused them by saying that delusion, the spirit of delusion upon them. It's all for you, my friend. You never are too late. Take this step forward and come forth. May Abba Yahweh will have mercy upon you. I am Messenger Daniel. Until next time, say Shalom Aleichem. Peace be unto thee.
Can you move a little?